Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome again to our Friday Bible teachings. Last Friday we talked of what happens in Bethel. And we saw that we are revived the moment we enter to the holy temple and the holy place of God. Thank you for continually listening to us. Thank you for encouraging us. Thank you for supporting us to this far. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we are delighted being before you. We pray that as we share your word, that you may continue strengthening our faith and standing by each one of us. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our today's guiding verse is taken from Genesis chapter 28, verses 15. Genesis chapter 28, verses 15. I will read. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go. I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. That is God speaking to his servant Abraham, reminding him that he will walk with him, he will go with him, he will never ever leave him. We have been learning about Bethel as our place of worship. We have been learning about Bethel as our place where we congregate, as a place where we enter to worship God, as an altar where we can go and lay all our needs and all our difficulties. Today I want us to think of the benefits of Bethel. Benefits of Bethel. All benefits of a place of worship. Benefits of having an altar beside you. What is worship? I want us to ask ourselves that question. Because when worship, and when we are worshiping together, this worship brings a single entity that is more important in our lives. It unites us together as believers. It plays a greater role, and also it rekindles the spiritual life and fire that we can continue moving forward. When you have a corporate worship, it brings together God's words, prayer, and a fellowship. This is the greatest means of God's ongoing grace in Christians' life. And what are some of the benefits that we attain from Bethel? One is assurance. As we have read from Genesis chapter 28, verses 15, beyond, I am with you and will keep you wherever you go. This is the assurance of God to us, that he will never leave us, he will never forsake us. And how comes that he will never forsake you during a time as this? COVID-19 has carried our emotions, has carried everything that we have. The Bible says, and he will keep us. He will keep you safe to the end of the journey, because he has promised. Another thing is, the benefits that you attain from Bethel, doors that were closed, they are opened. Doors that should not be opened, they are closed. When you read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 45, verses 2, the Bible says, I will go before you and will level the mountains. I will break down gates of bronze and cut through bars of iron. This is God speaking with Cyrus. He gives him the information that any gate, any circumstance, any obstacle, it might be of bronze, gold, silver, metal, it doesn't matter its form, but he informs him that I will break the gate. I will break the door for you trespassing everything. Remember Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. The Bible says, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you will find. But the last involves all. Knock and the door shall be opened to you. It doesn't matter who has closed the door. What matters is it will be opened when you call upon the name of the Lord. The other thing is chains of spiritual bondage and the strong odds are broken in the presence of God. A good example is in Acts chapter 16, verses 25. Verses 25 and 26. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God. And the one and other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was a such violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prison doors flew open and every chains came loose. Why? Because God's presence and goodness walked with them, and every chain that tied them was broken. The chains that are tying you, tying your family, tying your job opportunities, any chain that is tying your mind, that is tying your willing heart, when you enter to Bethel, a place of worship, every chain is broken. It falls away from you because God's goodness works with his people. The other thing is, when we enter to Bethel, another benefit that we attain is healing takes place. There is healing in the presence of the Lord. Through Jesus Christ, the way he has been doing wherever he went, the way he has been meant for us to enter in through his presence. And they receive the healing, spiritual healing, soul healing, and the body healing. That is in Luke chapter 5, verse 12. When the lepers entered before the Lord, he sanctified them, and they were well once again. When we go before the Lord, the benefit that he attained is healing. You want your family to be healed. You want your life to be healed. We want our nation to be healed. It's now our time to enter to Bethel, to enter to the altar of the Lord, to call upon the name of the Lord, and healing will be our portion. Another thing that we attain is deliverance. We are delivered from different snares of fallen. When you read in Exodus chapter 14, verses 13 and 14, the Bible says, do not be afraid, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. This is now a great assurance that God will deliver us from any fallout that devil sets beside us. Funny thing, it doesn't matter who is setting it. Nothing that is greater than God our Father, because he has promised that I, myself, the Lord, will deliver you from any snare fall. Do we need the deliverance of the Lord? What we need, let us appear before him in prayer, supplication, and thanksgiving. He is kind, and he will do it all for us. Another benefit is that evil is set away, running away from us the moment we trust and go before the Lord in Bethel. When you read in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 12, the Bible says, and of our struggle is not against the flesh and the blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the principalities, against all the powers of darkness and the world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. My brothers, my sisters, the battle that you are fighting, the struggle that you are struggling, is not of flesh or blood. All is spiritual. And the moment we fight the good fight, the Bible says, and he will stand by our side. For his presence will go with us. For his presence will go before us. This will bring deliverance and salvation in the hands of the enemy. Devil may use any way. Devil may use any tactic. But we have the tactic to use. Scripture and a prayer. Let us call upon the name of the Lord. And we will be set free from any battle the devil sets against us. The other benefit is that we are refreshed. When you read the book of Jeremiah, chapter 31, verses 25, the Bible says, I will refresh the weary and satisfy the faint. When we come into the heavenly presence of God, we are refreshed and renewed. Every day to us is a new day. It's a new testimony. It's a new experience. Any day and every day before the Lord is a wondrous day of God. He wants to know our hearts the moment we seek him, because he gives us peace. Do you find it difficult to set aside time for God to worship, that it may be renewed? Even the enemies have time to plan to fight you. They have time to plan to fight your family. They have even time to plan to fight each one of us. Take a moment and imagine over a tree. When there is sun, when it's dry, it seems to die. But when it is soaked in water, the sun rays has no effects on them. The same to us as believers. When we are struggling, it seems to be we are fainting. But when we enter to the holy presence of God, we are strengthened, because we are soaked in the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The last benefit that I want us to share is our faith is strengthened. When you read in Romans chapter 15, verse 13, the Bible says, May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in love. The Holy Spirit, the most potent evidence of God's assurance and presence in our lives, he confirms it through faith, for he strengthens us in our hope. Remember, the Bible says the eye of the Lord is on those who fear him, on those who hope in his steadfast love, in those whom seek his deliverance, and in those whom their souls seek him, even in times of death. For in times of famine and death, he will deliver them. Even in the most dire circumstances, even when we are faced with death, the Lord is there to support us and to strengthen our faith, not to grow weary. Faith is there, assurance of things of people, the convictions of things not seen. By faith, we understand the universe that was created by the word of God. so that a sin not meant out of nothing. And this is the faith that we have. My brother, my sister, we have a number of benefits that we gain when we worship God and when we enter to His holy place. These are some of them that He has shared today. May you practice them. May you practice. May you have your own time to go before the Lord. And He will never leave you nor forsake you. Remember our topic. Bethel is a place of worship. Our topic today was the benefits that we attain from Bethel as a place of worship. Let us pray. Without fainted heart, we humble before you. Strengthen us. Let your presence walk with us. Fight for us and show us your way. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome again, brothers and sisters, every Friday that we can celebrate together, that we can share together, that we can pray together, that we can continue ministering to one another soul, that we may enter to the holy place of God together. Shalom, may the blessings of God Almighty be with you and remain with you. Amen.